Hello everyone and welcome back. I'm Duke Silver. Today we're going to be playing Fisher King once again. Like I said, big nerf coming to Fisher King, so we're going to get all the Fisher King games in while we can. Beta Hub probably won't get pushed alive for a little bit. It's a huge patch, but still. We start off with getting a tie against a Golden Owl against Sunday Ada. Usually that's good for a couple damage, but I mean, being a 2x2 hero as well as getting that extra stat on our owl immediately is good enough to get the tie, although we do take some damage to Trophy Hunter there. We're gonna take the shield page there just to hopefully change our breakpoints with our owls here. I definitely should have taken that sword there. That was a huge mistake. We are gonna be able to sell our sword for a second unit though. It's not all hopeless anyways. Taking the sword there is just objectively correct, just to store the gold in case we didn't want to buy a character. We get to triple our owl here. Looks like we're just going to take Merlin's Tower. I think I like Merlin's Tower quite a bit, especially on Fisher King. I mean, if we can find our way into a double XP spell, then that could be absolutely huge. Not the best three shop of all time. We're just going to take a Dachshund and hope to set ourselves up for a farmhand. I think it's farmhand. Anyways, we take some more damage from duckling there, so we have taken a couple losses already here pretty early. Not ideal, of course. Again, these threes are, they're okay, but not exciting. We could take the crew member here. We could take the angel. We do have a couple of good characters. Just ignore that raid notification. This was recorded live on my Twitch stream, so every once in a while you're gonna see a notification pop up there. Just do your best to ignore it anyhow. We win one against Sisyphus here, giving them a chunk of stats. They are pretty low though at 13 there. Again, we really wanted to find the farmhand, but unfortunately it just hasn't shown up for us on 3.2 now. Farmhand's another one that has been heavily nerfed on the beta. I do like Pirate Cook, but without a crew member in the shop, we can't really take it. It is a great way to get food stats going. Food just in general on the beta. I should have said yesterday. If you're not playing on the beta, if you have the means or even want to a little bit, I would heavily suggest getting on the beta. There's some huge sweeping changes just for power level in general. All of level 2 and 3 have been very heavily I would say nerfed or tried to be balanced to make it so stat explosions aren't happening quite so often. There's that farmhand, but we're on 4. I don't think we're gonna take it. Also, free roll there is no free roll on the beta branch, which is being tested. A lot of people are very not happy about that. It's very polarizing. Personally, I'm a huge fan. I've played quite a few beta games now, I really like the removal of the free roll. I think I've said that on the channel once or twice here and there, but I just feel like removing the free roll makes you play your shops more. It also slows down the stat explosion, which I'm a big fan of, kind of slowing the game down a little bit and actually being forced to play the units in your shop is a positive for me anyways. We got some stats onto our Radiant Fairy there. We did have to play down, so we took some more damage. Down to 19. We're not on the brink of death or anything, but we are getting beat up pretty badly here. We're just going to take a Husky for the infusion of stats. The Dachshund can also buff it up a little bit. We just ignored the Milk Woman. Normally I take Milk Woman pretty aggressively on 4, but we don't really have any ways to get food stats on. Like the unupgraded Dachshund just isn't good enough. We are gonna take another Radiant Fairy. Unfortunately, we were looking for XP. We really wanted XP in that shop, but unfortunately it just didn't show up. So we ended up having to double up on our Blizzard there, which I mean it's not ideal, but it is still a double spell. We get our treasure next turn, and we also pop our Wishing Fountain this turn. So I think we just don't even want to cast Experience if we see it here. We definitely don't want to double it up at this point. Like, it just probably just doesn't matter. There's a Radiant Fairy triple, which I think I am going to sell for. I probably shouldn't, especially at 12 here. But I think I do go for it here. I think if I had to make that decision again, I might not do it. Although, things actually kind of worked out pretty well here. I could have taken the Witch Hunter's Talisman as sort of to be safe and try and keep our health total high, but I just say screw it. Let's go for the pirate map. Let's go for maximum upside here. Yeah, we get a lot of stats onto our pirate gunner there, and it ends up being enough to win pretty handily. Our wishing fountain pops into a magic mean, which then our level 6 treasure pops, and we get a holy grail as our level 7 treasure. So that's actually phenomenal, and the fact that none of that popped our treasure map is actually kind of nuts here, because now we can take literally any 5 and it'll upgrade and give us a treasure and pop our treasure map. So we can pick and choose whatever 5 we want here to trigger our level 7 treasure, and we just have kind of an absolutely nuts turn, a nuts sequence of events there with the magic bean into the holy grail into the treasure map here. So like I said, we kind of get paid off for taking a greedy line. We're just going to take the mat there, and because we got the golden mimic out of our level 7 treasure, we get to upgrade 4 characters with our holy grail, which is why I just jammed that map there. I might want to like try and get XP to get up to 6 and find golden 6s if I didn't have those extra shots at treasures, but I figured, you know, we can set ourselves up for potential stealth or the Galahad just gives us a good chunk of stats, and it means that we're not going to be bleeding health like we have been. We're just going to add Artemis to our hero here. I mean, we got a pretty big range character in the owl there at slot 1 then. These huskies are at the point where they're kind of awkward, so I think we're going to replace at least one of them here, and we're going to get the golden haymaker, and we're just going to lose Artemis immediately and get this Holly's gold, which means we can reposition and just get our ranged character in one there. Right, again, we just get those Galahad stats on our range character and our Radiant Fairy, and the Radiant Fairy is going to be wherever it lands is going to be enough to dominate our opponent here. And again, Haymaker is also another one that has been nerfed. Honestly, all farmers have been nerfed really heavily on the beta. So you can't exactly like you can play farmers and food, but it's a lot harder to get into. The preserve on basically all the early farmers have been cut to almost nothing, so like preserving food stats is way harder, and Haymaker now only gives 3-3 instead of 5-3, but with like the lower overall power level, like the 3-3 is not too bad. It's just the preserve that's really ends up making them take a huge hit. Anyways, we got a golden fisherman that I kind of glossed over, which did yield us a drum roll here, and so we've got our mimic drum roll going. So we are firmly in an extremely good spot. I would say we have to be the strongest in the lobby by a huge margin, and we are only on 6.0 right now with the golden with a double drum roll. What do you call it? Our golden haymaker, regular haymaker, and the golden fisherman. We are going to take the Nero here, the double entrance with all this preserve that we have from our haymakers is just going to be super good with this good boy that we picked up. Again, we win in dominant fashion here. There's another fisherman, which we are just going to jam. And there's another one, as well as another good boy. So we're just pairing up our sixes left and right. Not only do we hit our treasures in extremely fast fashion, but the shops are being very generous to us and just showing us basically everything that we want. Consider the Merlin, but we're not doing Milkwoman things, so Merlin's a lot less appealing. I'm just gonna lock an Ascendance here, and we're gonna golden probably one of the good boys, because honestly, there's no other level 6s that we really care about, I think. Again, we're not doing Milkwoman things, so we don't need like magic boost or mage gloves or whatever. So let's just fire off our ascendants on the golden good boy here. I mean, I guess like a doppelganger diamond or bottled lightning would be very good. But we're just gonna take the rune here, and that gives us a double dying breath, and make our our good boy absolutely enormous here already. They don't even pop one of our good boys, and we knock them out, bringing us to a top two here. Got a mage board. They do have the magic lamp, which will have popped at this point, so that is a little bit concerning. Although I'm not sure what catches them up to us at level 8 with only one turn. Like even Wish for Brilliance to copy a spell 14 times, I don't know if that does it like stat wise. Like I don't think they could get like an owl big enough to be able to tank all the stats that we're putting on our board here. As I was saying about the doppelganger diamond, we do find the doppelganger diamond. We did want to add that. We could copy two things and make two copies, but I think or it would be position one and two, so we would get the golden good boy and the Nero. So I just decided to go with the golden good boy. I think that's good enough here. I think I'd rather just have the haymaker, just adding more food stats to our farmers, since the Nero doesn't add food stats to our farmers, just in case this somehow goes. And apparently their lamp hasn't popped. I saw it on one tick. You should be able to see it at the beginning of their last turn, so I thought it had popped by now, but I guess not. And we just win. We win by a ton. Again, we have that one absolutely absurd turn, and the lobby just could never catch up to us, and we win in very dominant fashion once again. Just another Fisher King high roll. I mean, I guess I'm kind of showcasing why it needed to be nerfed with these especially with these last two. And to be honest, I've got at least 10 more Fisher King games. But they're mostly just like food comps, so like that's why I'm kind of hesitant to even upload them, because this is the same thing over and over again, which is pretty boring. And that's one thing that I think the beta has done really well is without the free roll, comps are a lot weaker. It's a lot harder to just get into the best stuff. So you actually have to navigate your way through the game, and you don't necessarily know where you're going to end up, or you can't really force things nearly as easily. So that's something I'm really enjoying. I'm playing a lot more diverse array of comps. I mean, of course, with farmers and food being nerfed, that does kind of open up a lot of other things. But yeah. Anyways, let me know if you enjoyed that. Please leave a like, comment, subscribe. I would very, very much appreciate it. I hope you have a fantastic rest of your day, and I'll see you soon.